guys. I'm back out here today on the South Rivanna River in Charlottesville, Virginia. I'm getting ready to head out for a training run today. I'm going to do at least 10, 12, possibly even 14 miles. When I left the house, I had 999 subscribers on my YouTube channel. So I think by the time I get back today, I will have hit 1,000. And I just wanted to stop and thank you all for subscribing to this channel. When I started this, I think back in 2013, I just took a few action cams down the river with me, mounted on kayaks, just to get it online to share with a few friends. I never dreamed that people from not only around the country, but from around the world would watch those videos and reach out to me and subscribe to this channel. So thank you, thank you, thank you. This channel's about kayaking, but I've gotten into doing fitness tracker reviews and product reviews for things that are loosely related to kayaking, health and fitness in some way, watches you can wear in the gym, wireless earbuds, things like that. I hope you understand the need to monetize this channel to offset my costs a little bit. I've got hosting fees. I've got a lot of fees associated with cameras and equipment, and the what I make on Amazon affiliates account is really almost nothing. Just as that started to build up, Amazon changed their commission scheme and screwed everybody. So, it's a few dollars per month. It's not huge money. So thank you for subscribing. The way to help this channel, if you don't want to donate to this channel or click through a link to buy something, or I also sell a set of ergometer plans. What that is, it's an indoor paddling device for people who want to train indoors in the wintertime. I sell plans on how to make one of those from a Nordic Trek ski machine, so go check that out. Again, the kayaking community is pretty small, so that's not a ton of money either. It's a very niche market, or if you're in France or anywhere else, a very niche market. So, that's not floating the boat in terms of all my expenses either. But I just want to say thanks. The best way you can help really is just subscribe to this channel, give my videos a thumbs up, and leave a comment if you would. And leave some feedback to let me know what products you'd like to see me review, and I'll try to get my hands on it. I reach out to these companies. Often I can get a review unit, but sometimes I just bite the bullet and buy them on my own. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you for 1,000 subscribers. I really appreciate it. I just thought, I would share a few videos, and then I thought, okay, after I'm long gone, it'll be kind of neat for my kids to be able to just go to YouTube anytime they want and see Dad rambling on about something stupid. So I guess I'm kind of leaving a little bit of a legacy behind too. Plus, hey, I love to go and rewatch some of my own videos just to relive races, to re-meet and just remember meeting some people. I've met some wonderful people over the years. I always get a kick out of it when somebody says, hey, you're Dave, I've seen your videos. And it's a stranger to me. So that's just really kind of neat. This has turned out to be a great way to meet people and help build the kayaking community. So plane's about to come over. I'm going to sign off. Thank you very much. I'm going to go hit the water. Take care. Hey guys, so I just got off the water. I did 12 miles today. It was a great day to be out. It was drizzly this morning when I got on. It was overcast and beautiful, nice and warm, but it was very overcast, so I didn't have to worry about the sun. Just in the last 10 minutes here, the sun has come out. But I would be remiss if I didn't talk a little bit about kayaking in this video. First of all, just remember my LOL methodology, my legs, obliques, lats. This is the time of the season where some of us who have gone easy all winter long are now really starting to get into more of a competitive racing stroke to get into shape for racing season. That's what I did today. And I could really just feel, all the power driving through my legs, transitioning through my obliques and the lats. So just focus on those three main muscle groups. And that's a sign that you're probably doing things correctly. And then one thing about paddle imbalances, I posted a video over the winter. It was somebody else's video discussing how to fix or correct paddle imbalances. That's when you're better on one side than you are the other. A couple years ago, I posted a video where I noticed I was out and there was a slight breeze blowing past my ears and I could just hear it. And when I would take my strokes, the sound of that wind would speed up and I could hear the frequency modulate. Well, turns out today was exactly one of those kind of days. I wouldn't call it wind, but that kind of draft you get when the air is going from a high pressure to a low pressure system. That's what I had this morning. And so there was a constant breeze, and I paddled straight into it, and I could hear the frequency of that wind going past my ears. And I could hear it increase when I would stroke on one side and then the other. And lo and behold, the imbalance I was working on, I was able to confirm I've pretty much gotten rid of it, because the pitch went up the same amount when I took the stroke on either side. So I think I got that imbalance fixed. So sometimes it's just the simple things in nature that you can pick up on that can really help you out as a paddler. And the sound of wind past your ears can be one of them. So, okay, take care. I hope you're doing well. And thanks for watching. And I'll be back with you soon.